So they're doing a biography of Anthony Bourdain. So they, like, the guy called me to, you know, talk to me about it. And I was telling him how I wrote the stage shows for him. And the thing was, is that he was like, how much, you know, and I gave him a deal and I didn't want to, like, you know, when you're like a comic, you're like, oh God, how much is, and so I gave him a bit of a cut rate, you know, and he was like, great, fine. And, but I still thought it was like, you know, fair amount of money. Then the guy told me, he goes, yeah, he made more on those stage shows than he did. He said he made more on those stage shows than any other part of his.
Yeah, I bet.
His
well,
career.
That's
like, oh my God, why didn't I ask for more money?
That's you
because
that,
you're always going to undervalue. That's what I mean. That's why you have to have agents and shit or managers.
Yeah, I'm just talking like, yeah, anything you want.
I can't even. I hate even thinking about like the stupidity I've had of like where I undercut.
$100 too much.
Oh my God. Oh, okay, $80.
Yeah.
So that's not a Me Too though, right? What's the Me Too? That's the
okay. So the Me Too is okay. So when I used to do like Red Eye and stuff, did you ever do Red Eye?
Yeah, I used to do Red Eye. Uh-huh.
Okay, so I would just like as a joke because it was live. Whoever I was sitting next to, and last time it was like a pundit of some kind, not a comedian. I would just put my hand on their lap, like while they were talking to get them to react.
What are you, Joe Biden?
I don't know anybody that was there. I was just sexually inappropriate, I guess. And then I just thought it was
yeah,
so
that's
funny.
The word. Wait, so you Me Too, you arrest him?
So we were on CNN and it was this live round table. It was like a big deal. Like people were taking it very
seriously. You knew him for a while. Let him know this wasn't the first time she ever, you know, they had a relationship. Like
the first time you took it to the next level.
Right. But he's not like, okay, so he was hosting the show and it's like, you know, when it's live, people are like, oh, you know. And
3, 2, 1.
Yes. And not only that, but it was like, it's sort of the backdrop was this bar. So there was like kind of extras like milling about in the back and stuff. And 3, 2, 1. And then, you know, and I put my hand on his lap and he,
whoa.
Like, I don't know why I thought that was going to be so funny. And he just,
that's fucking hilarious.
It was like not a comedy show. And he was like, tonight we go over poverty, blah, blah, blah. You know?
That is very funny. I have to say that's hilarious to do that. At a fucking
serious moment. But he didn't say anything. And then, so it was like 15 seconds, you know, my hand's still on. I don't know what to do now. I haven't thought it through.
Because Bonnie, the blowjobs are at like the secret after party. They're not.
I just took my hand off the lap. And nobody said anything. He never said anything. In the break, he introduced his wife who was standing, you know, off to the side. And I was like, oh, hi, nice to meet you. And, we never spoke of it. We never. I think he thought I just was like hitting on him. Because I can't get right. Because I can't get right.